Hello, and welcome to part three of the tutorials on rundown templates. In the last two tutorials, I showed you how to create a rundown template and then how to set up a broadcast using that rundown template. If you haven't watched those ones yet, go back and check them out before you watch this one, because in this tutorial, I'm going to go over how to run a broadcast using that rundown template that we created. Step one is creating it. Step two is using it to set up your broadcast. And now this is step three, which is actually running the broadcast. So because I'm recording this tutorial with AI Producer and I'm already in a Teams meeting and I can't be in two meetings at the same time, I'm going to show you a screen recording of a mock broadcast I put together for the purposes of this tutorial and ran using that rundown template. So I'll walk you through it as we watch that screen recording. And just so you know, for all of my live broadcast tutorials, I'm going to be using pre-recorded looping footage of my on-camera presenters that I'm running as bots, just so you can see the visuals, but these are not real broadcasts taking place. They're just for the purposes of these tutorials. Also, since this is just a tutorial, I'll be moving through the different segments a lot quicker than I normally would if this were an actual broadcast. Okay, so here I am joining the broadcast meeting that I set up earlier. And as soon as I am in the meeting, as always, I click on the AI Producer app to bring it into the meeting. And the control room panel pops up on the right-hand side. You can see here the status says starting soon. And above that, it says broadcast video not ready yet. First thing I do is check that my broadcast start time is correct. Then I click here on rundown, and my rundown will pop up here. And I quickly go through each segment to make sure I have all the correct presenters in the right segments and that all of my settings are correct. I just click on these three little dots here, and that will bring up these different options. I can delete a segment here. I can make changes to the segment here. And by hovering over these three lines, that brings up all this information. And most importantly, it shows me the selected presenter or presenters and the production format. And in this case, it is in fact the correct presenter, Matt Stewart, and the correct production format. This little play button would allow me to start the segment if the broadcast were live. I then click prepare, which will get the broadcast ready to go live. Now, normally my on-camera presenters would already be in this meeting, but since this is a tutorial and I'm using bots as my presenters, the process is just a little different. So now I am admitting my three presenter bots into the meeting. You'll notice that the starting soon bumper will appear and the viewers on the destination side will see that bumper. Normally it would have a countdown overlay with a countdown to your broadcast starting time right here. But since I am just recording for the purposes of this tutorial and don't have an actual live audience, I unselected the countdown overlay option. Something very important to note here. The broadcast will never just start automatically, even if you scheduled it for a specific time. You must trigger it manually in order to start the broadcast. And you do that by clicking on Start Broadcast, which you will see me doing now. So now the broadcast is officially live, and you'll see that the first segment is Matt in a split screen with the shared content, which is my screen share. This is the default focus mode that the AI will always start with if someone is sharing their screen and you are in presentation mode. The AI is running this broadcast by default, and you will see that the AI is switching between focus modes, between the presenter and the shared content. It is making those switches all on its own. Again, using the AI is like putting your broadcast on cruise control or autopilot. And the brilliant part about using the AI to run your broadcast, whether you are using a rundown or not, is that it will allow you to take your focus off of the production for as long as you need to take care of another task, for example, like taking an important phone call or answering an email. It just gives you a ton of flexibility during your live broadcast, and it's a really nice crutch to lean on anytime you need it. Although I could go into manual mode if I wanted to take the broadcast over by just clicking on manual mode, but I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to let the AI do all the work for this tutorial because there will be another full tutorial on how to run a broadcast in manual mode. And you'll notice the AI just made a switch there and cut to a split screen. So here in the control panel view, you can see that we are live in the Matt intro segment, and you can also see what segment is coming up next, which is Matt Sue Chat. And this is the countdown timer here to the next segment. Again, this is just a guide, and the segment will never switch to the next segment automatically. You will have to trigger that manually. This gives you complete control in case a presenter goes longer than expected, for example. You won't need to worry about their segment being cut short because you, as the producer, just follow the script and move on to the next segment when you know that current segment is over. So now that I know this segment is ending, you will see me clicking next segment, which will automatically bring me to the next segment, which is Matt and Sue talking in a split screen. Please note that there will always be a slight delay in your preview monitor, but you can be 100% confident that any switches that are being made either by you or the AI will be instantaneous on the viewer side, including the switching between segments. So again, we are in the second segment in the talk show format, and the AI is in control and would make all of the switching decisions for me if I stayed in this segment long enough. But as I mentioned earlier, I'm going to go through these segments quickly, so I'll move on to the next segment, which is the video that I selected when I set up this rundown. So all I need to do is click next segment, and it will bring up that video. Remember, I have all the presenters muted to the viewers, but I could unmute them here. And if I wanted to access the video controls, I could just click on rundown. Remember, this video is being pulled straight from the cloud, so you will never have to worry about any skipping or glitches, and the sound quality will be perfect. I set this segment up to end automatically once the video ends, so I'll let this video play out, and you will see that when it ends, it will automatically cut to the next segment. And there you go, it automatically switched to the next segment. This next segment is just one presenter, Matt, speaking with no shared content. Remember, when I set this segment up, I selected a fixed layout, which allowed me to choose the exact shot I wanted to use in this segment, which is what you are seeing right now. And so the AI will know not to make any switches during this segment. So as soon as Matt is done with his segment, I click on next segment, which will be a single presenter, Lynn, and a shared screen. And you can see the AI is doing its thing here and making all the switches for me. I could, of course, again, go into manual mode and bring in a custom layout if I wanted to, for example, but we'll save that for another tutorial. And once I see on my script that this segment has come to an end, I would click next segment, and it will cut to the second to last segment, which is a split screen featuring all three presenters in talk show mode in a triple split screen. And if you remember, in the last tutorial, I selected a custom layout for this segment, and the AI is now using it for this three split up here. And once that segment has wrapped itself up, I click next segment, and it will switch to my final segment with all three presenters below a shared screen because we are in the panel discussion format. And once I know the broadcast is ready to end, I just click stop broadcast. I will confirm it, and the broadcast will end, which will trigger the end bumper that I had selected when I set this up. And after the bumper finishes playing out, the viewers will see a screen with a text overlay saying broadcast has ended. And so that would be the end of the broadcast. You would just end the meeting, and if you selected OneDrive as one of your destinations, you'd get a notification shortly thereafter with a link to an MP4 of the recorded broadcast in 1080p. That's it for the third and final part of the tutorials on rundown templates. I hope they were helpful. Stay tuned for more, and I'll see you on the next one.